Good day, friends. It is me, HLModTech, and I am back with another awesome video. So let's get cracking. Friends, I have returned with another Tinkering in Tinkercad project. A user asked how to make a template with 144 holes in it. Let me show you what I got. So, of course, we're going to start a new 3D design. I'm not exactly sure what this looks like, but I'm going to call it 144. We're going to move over here to search, and we're going to type grid. There are several grids to pick from. I'm going to choose this one right here, and I like it because it lets me pick different polygons. So I do not know what sort of holes that user wanted. I'm going to just set this to 4, so it's a square hole. I do not know the size they wanted, but I'm going to set this to 3 just to show how you can adjust it. I'm going to keep the height at 20 because I'm going to cut them out in a minute. Friends, I doubt the user wanted this rotation, so I'm going to change the rotation by 45 degrees so that it's flat. And then I do know the user wanted 12 columns. I know that they wanted 12 rows. And this is where we run into our first glitch. It maxes out at 10. So friends, here's what we're going to do. I'm going to switch it to 6 by 6. Now I do not know the gap that they wanted in between them, but I'm just gonna have fun and I'm gonna put a gap in here. I know that it has to be larger than the shape, so I'm gonna do 8, and I'm gonna do 8. The radius of 3 meant I had a shape size 6. Now I'm gonna real quickly bring out my ruler, and I'm gonna put it right on the corner of one of these grids. I'm going to move my shape over, and I want to change the numbers to 0 and 0. Notice I already had 0 here, so when I snap that in, it fits perfect. Notice the 44.24. So friends, I'm going to do Control D, and I'm going to do Shift Nudge to move it over. And if I do 44.24 plus 44.24, you can see that they line up in touch. So friends, those are matched up side to side. Our gap should be 6 and 8. So there should be 4 here. Let's change this to 48.24 and see how it looks. 48.24 and press enter. I think that looks pretty darn fantastic. So now we can grab all of those, do Control D, once again, shift nudge down. And we do know now that we want this number right here, negative 50, to be 48.24, and press enter. It went the other way. If I'd have done negative, that'd be fine, but I'm gonna just leave it like that. All right, friends, I'm gonna shut that off for a second. Let's select this entire shape and do Control G. I'm gonna bring it down closer to the middle of our project, and let's use it to cut holes. So I'm bringing out a cube. Let's check our measurements. This right now is at 92. So if I hold down shift and I stretch this, I'm gonna type 100. It scales to 100 on every side. This side I'm gonna change to 2 millimeters thick. Once again, since this is a large group, I can now grab the two. I can choose a line and I wanna put it in the middle. And I always like to look at it from a corner and middle. Friends, just like that, select them, do Control G, and you have instantly got a 12 by 12 grid. How cool is that? Now I've got something even better for you. What if you wanted circular holes? Watch this. Control D. Shift nudge to move this one off to the other side. We are going to ungroup, and we're going to ungroup. This, my friends, is why we chose the polygon. If we max the sides to 32, check it out. You have instantly got circular holes. Slide, slide. If you needed to change the measurements, like if those weren't what you wanted, once again, you go to your radius. Let's say this time I type 2.5, and instantly it adjusts to the exact sizes you want. How cool is that? Now I'm going to take that back to the 3, just because that is what I was making for this one. I do not have to group the holes. If I did, I would grab them from this direction, so I didn't get those. I can just at this point grab all 5 shapes and do Control G and group it. There you are, friends, 144 square holes, or circular holes, or even any other polygon you wanted, pretty darn easily. Friends, I want to thank Thomas again for the question, and of course, I hope you all take time to join Tinkering with Tinkercad. Friends, I want to take a moment to remind you about my website, HLModTech.com. I have got a page dedicated to Tinkercad, tons of amazing categories for you to check out, day one favorites, some useful starters, and then finally the Tinkercad essentials. Finally, friends, down on the right there is the sweet built-in messaging tool. You can click that button, add your question, comment, or suggestion, and reach me almost instantly. Friends, I do also want to mention the link to the Tinkercad community Discord. As you can see, we have more than 700 members, and it is a fantastic place to talk everything Tinkercad. Finally, friends, if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. Please also hit that share button so more people can learn about HL ModTech. Don't forget, you absolutely make my day if you take time to leave a comment down below. And if you haven't subscribed yet, what are you waiting for? Smash that subscribe button. And last but not least, hit that notification bell if you want to be the first to know when there's a brand new video from me, HL ModTech. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.